with the point standings. Here we go.
Need to pick up this Rift Scuttler, which he should be able to gather for himself some valuable, immovable intel here for Gen G.
And I think that right now what's really happening here.
Okay, the Ken's maneuver here as Bono's looking for a kidnap. Connects the dots and is able to get them back forward. First blood goes over to Sungyoon and should be able to make it another one. Double kill. Outer turret in the mid lane. That's going to be it. Decision they can make is Roach is going to get a lot of value out of that riposte, and Flash is actually, he's looking to chase after Tal, but he can't tank this turret, as if that morning mist landed, that's so much damage coming in, and there we go, Bono's able to finish him off.
He's the edge,
he's going
really
too
excited.
Fast, yeah. Too fast, misses the turn,
oh, no.
And now we've got a kidnap, now we've got a very dead Karma, and we've got Gen G falling apart.
Now, Pure does have teleport available, so we'll have to see if Hanwha Life can actually repel the Zac and guarantee that he can't enter or the Lee Sin.
Peanut is going to get kicked back by Lava. Really nicely done to get the Lee Sin out of the pit. That's 100% chance of gathering themselves the Baron buff. So come back and help us out. He's like, all right. Just to give you the synopsis on what happens in the two towers, is that's going to be base broken bottom side of the map as well. It's in goes Sungyoon. He gets completely impatient, but it pays off as he destroys Ruler. Kidnap successful. Both mid laner and AD carry have been removed as Peanut gets a cute kick, but it's only that. It's only cute as they have to watch these Nexus turrets fall. We're going to game number three as Hanwha Life, a beautiful redemption match. After Gen G fell apart, bottom side of the map, we can tell the time.